This looks like an ordinary gray board, but from a different point of view, through this camera, you can see a beautiful rainbow. Isn't it very nice? Rainbows usually appear only when it rains, but instead of raindrops, this board is covered with thousands and thousands of tiny glass beads, and they, the beads, make the rainbow. Now we're chasing rainbows, in answer to a question sent in by Mrs. W.A. Lynn of Gibbon, Nebraska, who writes, why is a rainbow curve? You know, she actually speculates it might be the pot of gold that bends it toward the Earth. Interesting guess. Here with a more scientific answer is Jack Netland, high school physics teacher from Osseo, Minnesota. Welcome to the program, Jack. Good to see you again.
Thank you, Ira. Nice to be here.
Are you ready to tackle the question, why is a rainbow curve?
Oh, yes, I am. In order to talk about rainbows, you're talking raindrops.
You're talking raindrops.
Okay. All right. What we have is a model here of a raindrop, pretty good-sized raindrop, but it's round like a raindrop.
Beaker filled with water.
If you would turn on the sun over there.
You captured the sun in here.
Yes, indeed.
I have a sun coming
in. And take the little screen there and place it in front of here, I think you will see a rather distinct spreading out of colors.
Oh, look at that. You've created our own little rainbow right here. The light from the box is actually going into the glass with the water in it and coming back out.
Yes, it is.
Creating a rainbow.
Spread into its colors.
Well, let's talk about that. What's happening inside of our rainbow?
Let's take a look at another raindrop here.
This is a big raindrop.
Big raindrop, cut in half. The light from the sun comes in like so. It enters this side of the raindrop, and it starts to bend into its colors right here. It bounces off the back of the raindrop, goes out here, bends again, and spreads out even further into the colors. Mm-hmm. Now, what that means is that it makes a very definite angle here between the incoming light and the refracted or spread out light. Mm-hmm. And that angle is about 42 degrees, roughly.
So you have to have at least that angle or that angle to create this bending and bouncing to come out like this.
And all of the raindrops do it.
Now, let me ask this question. If this is happening all the time during a rainstorm,
it is.
How come you don't see rainbows everywhere? It's only a rare occasion that you see a rainbow.
Sure. Well, the rainbows are appearing everywhere.
They are everywhere.
You can't see them unless you look directly where the light is coming. The light must get right into your eye from that color.
I see.
Now, that makes it necessary that the sun is low in the sky, usually, either the morning or the evening, and the sun has to be behind you and the raindrop in front of you in order to see that.
Oh, no, to create this angle here.
Yes.
I see.
Now, in order to understand it a little better, we've got another arrangement back here.
Oh, lots of rainbows.
This represents the billions and billions. We've got rain falling here.
So each one of those is a raindrop.
Well, yes, and it could represent lots of raindrops.
Mm-hmm.
You'll notice that from the top one here, we get a band of red that comes to that point.
Right.
From this one, we get a green band, and from this one, we get a band of purple or blue. Now, if you put your eye down there, now the light from all of them is getting into your eye, which is necessary for you to see them.
But I'm only seeing the red from the top one and the green from the middle. So even though it's producing all those colors, as you say, I'm only seeing a particular color from a band of raindrops.
That's correct. The rest
That's
of the
amazing.
Colors, for example, here, those are going off to somebody else. And he is seeing his rainbow over there.
He's seeing a different rainbow than I'm seeing? Everybody sees different rainbows?
Your very own rainbow.
I didn't know that. That is fascinating.
It is interesting, and it makes it kind of special in a way.
Absolutely. Now let me ask you this question. You have explained very well, Jack, what rainbows are, but you haven't explained the question that's been asked, how come rainbows are curved?
Yeah, I think we have enough information now. We can go back over here to our little model of this person walking in the hill, and let's call him Ira.
Okay.
Ira's out there walking.
He's even got a mustache.
I think so, yes. He's walking out in the hill and dale, and he sees a bunch of rain over here. This is a sheet of billions and billions of raindrops.
Okay.
And they're coming down this way, and you can imagine then that here again is our angle, our 42-degree angle, the light from the sun coming from over there.
Right.
Okay. Now, I want you to take that and hold it so that the light comes to Ira down there.
Okay.
In that way. Okay. Now, move it someplace.
All right. I'll move it around here.
Okay. Now you'll notice that's not pointing at him anymore.
No, the light's not reaching him there.
No, not from there.
If I move it here, the rainbow's not reaching him.
Not from there.
So the only place it's going to hit him like this is if I rotate it.
If you rotate it like that, you're going to get an area that is swept out like this.
Sweep out the rainbow.
The rainbow. That's why it's curved.
That's very, very interesting. Now, if the land weren't here, if I could sweep it even further.
Yes.
I would get a circle.
A circle.
A complete circular rainbow.
Yes.
Can you ever see a circular rainbow like
that? Sure. If you're high enough in the air, an airplane, for example, and the sun is at the right angle, you can see a complete circle of a rainbow, yes.
One more question about this, Jack, because I'm really interested now. A lot of times you see double rainbows. You not only see this one band, but you see another band on top of it.
Yes, like this right here, a beautiful picture of a double rainbow. What we have is this, is the primary rainbow here, and then here is the secondary rainbow. Now, this one is caused from two bounces inside the raindrop.
Instead of the one that causes this one.
Right. This gives you a 42-degree angle. This, because of the extra bounce, gives you a 51-degree angle. It appears at a different place.
That's fascinating. And it's not the pot of gold on the end of the rainbow that's curving it down.
Oh, no, it's not that at all. But if you could get to the end of the rainbow, I could guarantee you a pot of gold.
That's a big boast, Jack.
Well, it's
putting
because,
your reputation on a line.
Oh, well, it's because you can't get there.
Why can't you get there?
If you go to where you think the rainbow is,
right.
Remember, the angle's got to stay the same.
Right. The rainbow's going to move.
Rainbow
so
moves.
I keep going toward the rainbow, and the rainbow keeps getting further away from me.
But if you could get there, the pot of gold would probably look like this.
Well, thank you very much, Jack, for this colorful and now very enriching explanation. We'll have more in a minute.